Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today we are going to study the placenta and its abnormalities. The learning outcomes. At the end of this lecture, students should be able to describe the various functions of placenta, able to identify various types of placental abnormalities, and able to explain risks to the fetus in case of abnormality in the placenta. The placenta is an organ which develops in the uterus during pregnancy to provide nourishment to the developing fetus. The trophoblasts proliferate rapidly and invade the surrounding decidua soon after the implantation. As invasion of the endometrium proceeds, maternal blood vessels are invaded, forming intervillous spaces. As you can see in this picture, this is the normal placenta and the uterus, and you can clearly see the cord which is attached to the umbilicus of the baby, and baby is taking nourishment in the form of blood through the placenta from the mother. So what is the structure of placenta? It measures 15 to 20 centimeter in diameter, 2 to 3 centimeter thick, and weighs 1/6 of the fetus, approximately 500 grams. For example, if the baby is of 3 kg, then the placental weight will be 500 grams. It has two surfaces. One is the fetal surface, another is the maternal surface. यानी एक जो सरफेस होती है वो बच्चे की तरफ होती है और एक सरफेस मदर की तरफ होती है, जहाँ से प्लेसेंटा वो जो मदर मैटरनल सरफेस होती है वो यूट्रस के साथ अटैच होती है और वो ब्लड सप्लाई ब्लड वेजल्स के थ्रू ले रहा होता है और वो भी ट्रांसफ़र कर रहा होता है फीटस की तरफ, और जो फीटल सरफेस है वो फिर थ्रू द अम्बिलिकल कॉर्ड बेबी के साथ अटैच्ड होती है. द शाइनिंग एमनियन अंडर विच आर वेजल्स प्लास्टर्ड बाय द कोरियन. Both arteries and veins are present on the fetal surface and the insertion of the umbilical cord. On the maternal surface, it contains irregular lobes divided by septa made up of connective tissue. There are usually 16 to 18 of these irregular lobes which are called cotyledons. These cotyledons are formed during placentogenesis. They only become larger as pregnancy advances. तो जैसे जैसे प्रेगनेंसी एडवांस करेगी, यूट्रस भी ग्रो कर रहा है, बेबी भी ग्रो कर रहा है, तो साथ प्लेसेंटल साइज भी इंक्रीज हो रहा है. अ लिटिल बिट टू अंडरस्टैंड द फीटल सर्कुलेशन. फीटल ब्लड फ्लोज फ्रॉम द प्लेसेंटा थ्रू टू अम्बिलिकल आर्टरीज इन विच डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड और वीनस ब्लड इज ट्रांसपोर्टेड. The blood vessels branch rapidly and form capillary networks in the terminals. Oxygenated blood returns to the fetus from the placenta through the single umbilical vein. So you see the fetal circulation, there is opposite of the adult circulation, that is ki arteries mein deoxygenated blood hota hai aur oxygenated blood vein mein hota hai, umbilical vein mein hota hai. There are two umbilical arteries and one umbilical vein. The maternal blood reaches the placenta propelled by the maternal arterial pressure. There is no admixture of maternal and fetal blood. Venous exits are scattered at random over the entire base of the placenta. So in this picture you can see this is the normal placenta, and this shiny surface over which there is attachment of the umbilical cord, this is the fetal side of the placenta. The maternal side is opposite to it. So on the fetus, this side of the placenta is visible, and as you can see the blood, there is a group of blood vessels running all over the placenta, and the shiny amnion and chorion is visible, and the Wharton jelly umbilical cord is also visible. So this is the normal placenta. Understand this picture. The for the transfer of substances, as we learned earlier, that the deoxygenated blood is carried from the baby to the placenta via the umbilical arteries, and then oxygenated blood from the mother to the baby is carried via the umbilical vein. Now the functions of the placenta. There are various functions of the placenta. First, the number one is the exchange function. Waste products from the placenta cross the placental membranes to the maternal blood. The waste products from the placenta कहाँ से आते हैं? The waste products baby से जो जाते हैं, waste products वो placenta में जाते हैं, placenta से maternal blood में जाते हैं. Oxygen, nutrients and protective antibodies from the mother are transferred to the fetus. Endocrine function. There are various endocrine functions of the placenta. As you can see, there are various hormones which are produced by the placenta, and they play a major role in the growth and development of the baby, not only the baby, also the developing pregnancy. So these are very important. The placenta produces chorionic gonadotropin, human placental lactogen, chorionic thyrotropin, chorionic adrenocorticotropin, hypothalamic like releasing hormones of the placenta, pregnancy specific proteins, estrogen, progesterone and prolactin. So these are the hormones which are produced by the placenta. Now coming towards the placental abnormalities. Placental abnormalities क्या क्या हो सकती हैं? तो normal placenta आपने देख लिया कि कैसा होता है, discoid shape होता है, उसकी एक maternal surface होती है, एक fetal surface होती है, center में cord attach होती है and all that. But there are some abnormalities in the development of the placenta. These are the placenta bipartita, tripartita, circumvallate or circummarginate placenta, subcenturate placenta, battledore placenta, placenta accreta, placenta increta, placenta percreta and placenta previa. All these are the abnormalities in the development or location of the placenta. So what is placenta bipartita and tripartita? There are two or three of the placentas. When there are two placenta, then we say placenta bipartita, and when there are three, it is tripartita. Do not confuse it with the monochorionic or dichorionic multiple pregnancies, because that is some very different thing. Because in that multiple pregnancy, you can see that when two babies are developing in dichorionic or diamniotic pregnancies, then also the two placentas are also developing individually. But in this case, in the singleton pregnancy, you can see there is the development of two placentas or the three placentas. So this is a normal thing that with a single baby you see two or more placenta. So these placentas are with equal dimensions, attached to one umbilical cord. Clinical importance is that one of them may left in utero after normal delivery, which may cause postpartum hemorrhage. So सबसे बड़ा खतरा क्या है? Normally सबको पता है कि एक अगर singleton pregnancy है, एक baby है, तो उसके साथ एक placenta ही आएगा. जो attending midwife है, doctor है, obstetrician है. अमूमन पेशेंट्स हमारे पास इस तरह आते हैं जो अनबुक्ड होते हैं, इमरजेंसी में आए हैं, नॉर्मल डिलीवरी हुई है, बेबी भी डिलीवर हो गया, प्लेसेंटा भी डिलीवर हो गया और डिलीवरी ख़त्म हो गई. थोड़ी देर बाद क्या पता चलता है जी पेशेंट सीवियरली हैवी ब्लीड कर रही है, पीपीएच में चली गई है, शॉक में चली गई है. तो जब दोबारा एक्सप्लोर किया जाता है तो अंदर एक और प्लेसेंटा मौजूद होता है. तो दिस इज़ द ड्रॉबैक कि जब प्लेसेंटा बायपार्टीटा या ट्राईपार्टीटा होता है तो उसमें ये यूजली मिस हो जाता है और दैट कैन कॉज पीपीएच एंड अल्टीमेटली रिजल्ट्स इन मेजर मॉर्बिडिटी और मोर्टेलिटी ऑफ द पेशेंट इफ नॉट इंटरवीन्ड टाइमली. सो इन दिस पिक्चर, दिस इज द डायग्रामेटिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन. यू कैन क्लियरली सी देयर इज वन कॉर्ड एंड टू प्लेसेंटा इन द बायपार्टीटा and the cord and three placenta in the tripartita. So the next is circumvallate or circummarginate placenta. This is present in 1% of the placentas. There is a small central chorionic plate, that is the placenta is basically very small and surrounded by a thick whitish ring composed of a double fold of amnion and chorion. It predisposes to premature marginal separation causing APH, premature delivery, premature death. होता क्या है? एक प्लेसेंटा होता है, वो प्लेसेंटा क्या है, जो बेसिकली मेन बल्क है प्लेसेंटा का, वो स्मॉल होता है दरमियान में, और बाकी सारी सिर्फ मेम्ब्रेन्स ही होती हैं इर्द गिर्द. तो प्लेसेंटा उसकी, उससे होता क्या है कि प्रीमेच्योर डिलीवरी हो सकती है, प्रीमेच्योर डेथ हो सकती है बेबी की, बेबी को इनएडिक्वेट सप्लाई ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स हो सकती है, इनएडिक्वेट एक्सचेंज एंड एंडोक्राइन फंक्शंस हो सकते हैं, और एपीएच हो सकता है, दैट इज दैट कैन लीड टू मेजर मॉर्बिडिटी एंड मोर्टेलिटी ऑफ बोथ द मदर एंड द फीटस. सो यू कैन सी इन दिस पिक्चर देयर इज अ स्मॉल प्लेसेंटा एंड विच इज सराउंडेड बाय द थिकेंड एमनियन एंड कोरियम. The next is the succinurate placenta. It is inappropriately divided placenta. One is a large placenta and a small succinurate lobe is present, and the clinical significance is that the small lobe could be forgotten in utero following a normal delivery, and which results in PPH as we saw in the case of bipartita and tripartita, that one placenta can be forgotten or left in utero. Same is the case with succinurate placenta, that whole placenta is delivered and a small lobe is left behind after the normal delivery, and it will cause the uterus to become atonic and results in PPH and heavy bleeding. So as you can see in this picture, the major placenta is there, and there is a small placenta or succinurate lobe also attached, which is usually forgotten in the normal vaginal delivery. The battledore placenta, where the cord is inserted marginally, clinical significance is that the umbilical vessels could run through the membrane and may rupture, causing the fetal bleeding. This is usually also called the vasa previa, and it is a very fatal condition in which there is the bleeding is all of the fetal origin, and it causes fetal demise within minutes. So this is a very dangerous type of dangerous cause of APH. Vasa previa is a major cause of APH and results in fetal demise immediately. So as you can see, the battledore placenta, the cord is attached at the margin of the placenta. In the normal placenta, previously you saw that the placenta, in the normal placenta, the cord was attached in the center of the placenta, but in battledore placenta or marginal placenta, the cord is attached at the margin of the placenta. So it can result in major bleeding result due to vasa previa. Next is placenta accreta. Trophoblastic invasion of the endometrial basement membrane, it causes placenta accreta, that is we usually say morbidly adherent placenta. कि placenta क्या है कि वो endometrium की जो basement membrane है उसको invade कर जाते हैं जो trophoblast होते हैं. तो during delivery क्या होता है कि वो placenta deliver करना difficult होता है, वो morbidly adherent होता है, and that can result in into PPH and also ultimately can result in the hysterectomy. Placenta increta, where there is invasion of the myometrium. Placenta percreta, there is perforation of the uterus, that is the placental trophoblasts have invaded the myometrium, not only the myometrium but also reached up to the serosa of the uterus, and may also invade sometimes bladder or posteriorly into the rectum. So in all these cases the patient ends up in the emergency hysterectomy and this is the life saving procedure. Now the umbilical cord. What is umbilical cord? The cord between, which is attaching one side towards the baby's umbilicus and the other to the placenta. This is the cord which contains two arteries and one vein, and it performs a major function of exchange and transport between the mother and the fetus. The umbilical cord is 30 to 100 cm in length, average 55 cm. 1 to 2.5 cm thick, has two arteries and one vein. The vessels are embedded in a whitish substance called Wharton jelly. It is inserted centrally, laterally or marginally. There is also velamentous insertion, which is a rare insertion, and it also has a serious side effects. I will tell you later on. In velamentous insertion, the cord stops at some distance before sending down vessels like the maize stem. These vessels could be found in the lower uterine segment and may bleed during contractions or the vaginal examination, which can result in heavy antepartum hemorrhage, heavy bleeding during the vaginal examination or during the contractions. So you can see the insertion of the cord here, the central, lateral insertion, marginal insertion and the velamentous insertion. In the velamentous insertion, you can clearly see that the vessels are traveling outside the margin of the placenta, which can be damaged easily during contractions or the vaginal examination and can result in antepartum hemorrhage, which can cause major morbidity and mortality in both the mother and the fetus, if not intervened timely. In the first picture, you can see the succinurate lobe of the placenta. Then in the upper right, you can see the circumvillate placenta, small placenta surrounded by the thick membranes. And next to it is the marginal insertion or battledore placenta. And last picture, you can clearly see the velamentous insertion of the cord, in which the cord ends and then the vessels are running towards the placenta. This is again the same picture explaining the same thing. Thank you.